Today is a sad day as we say goodbye to the raven as we know it. The raven was faithful and ran like a champ in the summer heat, winter frost, and heavy dew. It collected many photons, meteors, and Starlink satellites. The mini's PC powered up and connected to the Wi-Fi with only a couple hiccups over the years. It never asked questions as to why I was attaching another fishing weight to its back as I attempted to even its weight out. The Raven even tolerated the many redesigns I gave it over the years. Yet today we say goodbye. Today I will redesign it once again. I will give it wings of strength and reliability. I will give it power like it has never seen before. So dear Raven, like the phoenix, you will be reborn as an eagle. Everybody, it's Amy Astro and welcome back to my channel. This week we have a fun video for you. This is going to be me redesigning my Raven telescope and we are going eagle. We are going to soar high and fly just like an eagle. But today, as you see, we are taking apart the Raven. And the bonus of this is we're going to do things just a little bit different. We're going to be removing the mini PC, the Pegasus Astro Ultimate Power Box, all of the brackets I had done, the guide scope, and everything. And we're going to slim this telescope down because we're going to combine everything in one very powerful unit. And that's going to be the Eagle 4S. Now, I was very fortunate that I reached out to the manufacturer, PrimaLuce, and I asked them if they had any of the refurbished Eagles in stock. And well, they didn't at that moment, but they remembered my request. And when one did show up in their shop, they reached out to me and we started to work together. And the bonus of working with a refurbished one, and I worked with the US representative, is he was able to update it completely like it's brand new off the shelf, and we did a few minor upgrades to it. Upgrades is, well, I went ahead and got a new hard drive put in it that was much larger. I doubled the memory, and yeah, it's going to be a beast. So even though it says it's a 4S, it is way beyond a 4S. With minimal effort on my part, a lot of effort on their part, but it was so much fun talking about this and how we wanted to get it all together. And the bonus was being a refurb and getting it done here in the US was I was able to log on to it while it was still sitting on their desk, install all of my software, you know, across the US and get everything set up just the way I wanted it. And they even threw in a backup disk for me. Well, a USB, you know, flash drive and all that. And that was really exciting. And the customer service was just literally out of this world. But as you can see that I am showing you, I've got the Raven, their ECCO, which is their climate unit. And I had gone ahead and I tried their rings. And the rings are beautiful, but the problem was I needed 120 millimeters and they had 115 or 125. So no matter how much I tried to get the Eagle rings to work for me, I was just not able to do it. But I decided to go with a full theme of red and black. So this is going to be one sharp looking telescope. Now I added some risers underneath the rings, just so the body of the telescope and my night crawler did not hit the ground when I had it sitting on the table. And those are just about 20 millimeters tall. And then I had to add dovetail clamps to the top of my rings just so I can get things to mate up. And that's because I was not able to thread from the underside of the rings up through to the eagle like I would have been able to do if I had their rings. And I wasn't too crazy about that, but you work with what you have. Now, if my original rings had an inset for the screws, it would have been a whole lot easier. But it took me a few tries to get this together and a few weeks in between recording all this for me to get all the parts that I needed. I had to go ahead and get some dovetail clamps. I went and got a couple more Los Mondi bars to get everything hooked up. But the fun part was for me to figure out the spacing that I needed to have for these rings to keep everything nice and even. And once I had these arranged, I decided to go ahead and see how I was going to mount on the ECCO unit. And I used the existing dovetail clamp that was already on the Nightcrawler. I ended up having a couple clearance issues when I realized how the wirings were going to come out of the unit, and I toyed with the idea of mounting it elsewhere. But ultimately, I found that if I rotated the body of the Nightcrawler, I was able to get everything to work out pretty well. But it's really nice when a manufacturer sends all of the little bits you need to install something. I had to install two little grub screws onto the unit so it attached to the dovetail, and then I just slid it right in. And here you can see I am addressing where the wiring is going to hit. And I'm loosening up the grub screws on the Nightcrawler so I can rotate the flange around just a little bit. I really love doing these kind of projects because you can let your imagination roll with seeing how everything needs to go together and come up with a vision that you want. You know, my goal was to try to keep everything lined up so my balance would be, you know, down the center. And I was a little bothered by having this little unit hang off to the side, but eventually I was able to get it as close as possible to the Nightcrawler body once I put the cabling on. And I don't think that's going to mess with my balance too much because it is really small for a unit. And, you know, the pictures make it look like it's absolutely huge, but it's small. I mean, it's like the size of a Tic Tac box small. Well, now I'm going to be attaching a smaller dovetail rail to the bottom of the eagle. And this is so I can attach it to my telescope using the dovetail clamps that I've already mounted onto the rings. Now be extremely careful with how long these screws project into the eagle. They give you a wide assortment of screws in the package, which was terrific. And I lined it up and then I looked through to the side just to make sure it did not go too far into the eagle because you don't want to damage any of the electronics on the inside. But I'll tell you what, having the large quantity of screws available along with the many holes in the unit itself made it really easy to line things up. And you know, I just really, really liked putting all this together. Well guys, this is how I've got everything connected as of right now. I still have to go back and add all the wirings, but you can see I've got a few pockets along the side where I can put the cables and zip tie them down so they won't be flying all over the place. But I'll tell you what, this is one sharp looking telescope now, all red and black. It's compact. There's not a whole lot going on, but what you may notice here is, wait, I don't have a guide scope. I wonder what she is doing. Well guys, in the next video, I'm going to show you how I'm going to address guiding, and I think you're really going to like this, all right? So stay tuned for the next video. Well guys, I'm Amy Astro, and I appreciate you hanging out with me today. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share this with all your astro friends. I am having a lot of fun with these builds, and I cannot wait to get this one out underneath the stars. I'm wishing you guys great health, clear skies, and remember, I love each and every one of y'all. Goodbye, y'all.